Hey YTPC, tonight I finally get to sit at the cool kids table. Gonna be trying some St. Bruno. Gonna be smoking it in my brand new G. Spitaletti Black Labatt that I just did the Yabo for yesterday. I've seen a lot of channels talk about St. Bruno, and somebody mentioned, you know, all the cool kids are doing it. So I kind of felt like this little clip here because I hadn't tried it.
Full extension is very important. No pain, no gain.
Let's get it opened up and see what the tin note is like. Now, I did get the ready rubbed version. And I prefer that to the flake. It's pretty moist. I get the raisins, maybe a little fig. There's something else in there. It's not the grassy that I'm smelling. It's another, might be the floral stuff. That Lakeland essence that they talk about. All right, I'm going to get the bowl loaded up and then I'll be back. Now in the pouch, it's looks like that. So I don't know what kind of cut you call that. It's really long and stringy. So it looks more like a broken up flake than it does a, but maybe it's ready rubbed, I don't know. Yeah, I did let it dry a little bit, maybe about 10 minutes, because it was pretty moist straight out of the pack. So I'm going to do a little char light and then see what I get impressions off of that. And then I'll let it rest and come back and do the true light. Getting a little bit of raisin, and maybe I'm getting some of that floral essence because I've not tasted it before. Okay, I'm gonna let this rest for a minute, and then I will be back and do the true light. Okay, I'm getting maybe a little bit of citrusy. Wouldn't say lemon, maybe closer to a lime hint. But there's definitely a something different in there that I haven't tasted before. So I guess maybe it's that Lakeland or that floral essence, but it's very nice. I mean, for I guess this is an over-the-counter blend, but it's really good. It's not, I've only tried one local over-the-counter blend, and that was Bokrum Rift Bronze, and it was horrible. Yeah, this is different enough to be very interesting to me outside of anything else that I have. So I will probably keep that in the mason jar and restock it as it runs down. I probably won't buy a ton of it in bulk, but it's very good. But that different taste that I like, I can see where maybe somebody wouldn't like it. It's very different from any of the blends I've tried. Yeah, it's really good. Really moist out of the pack, though. I probably, if it doesn't settle down a little bit, I'll probably give it 15 minutes. I only gave it 10 minutes this time. Well, I'm just getting started with it, really. I'm going to smoke it down to about halfway and come back with this video. I'm also going to do some VRs in the middle. So I will catch you when I'm about halfway through the bowl on this. Okay, I'm about halfway down now. I did have to actually dump ashes out of this bowl. I normally don't have to do that when I'm smoking tobacco. I don't know if it's the long ready rub flake type cut this thing has, but the ash was just too thick. I actually had to tap, dump, and then relight. But I normally smoke the ribbon cuts and whatnot, or I use my flake grinder if I'm smoking flakes. But it's a re I really like this blend. And maybe it is the Lakeland or that floral essence. And sometimes I'll get hints of citrus, but this one really, to me, this one really has it. And I know everybody's tastes are different, but this is so different from anything that I have that I like. This is perfect for me to throw in to break up, because right now I'm on an English kick and I could see myself wanting to reach for this. I know some people say, you don't try tobacco. I'm gonna have to try this one. I don't like doing the relights. And I've only got one or two that I find that I need to do that for. And 10 or 15 minutes in my little tobacco tray, and then it burns like I like it. I don't have to do a bunch of relights. I usually get it going and that's it. But I have been chooching the heck out of this pipe trying to keep this bowl lit. And beautiful pipe, Giuliano. Beautiful. And normally, when I chew this much, I sometimes get some gurgle, but nothing yet. And I don't know if it's the longer shank on this one. But now I kind of see why everybody talks about it being good. I've never heard anybody say anything bad about St. Bruno. And I can be at the cool kids table. And it does, it has changed a little bit. The further I go, or if I take, you know, if I chooch a little bit on it, it loses the citrus and it goes all to that floral, or I can't say that it's Lakeland because I don't know what a Lakeland is. All right, so that's my impressions on it halfway. I'm gonna smoke it down to the bottom third and then come back. But in the meantime, let's hear a word from our sponsors.
Satisfying St. Bruno, patron saint of pipe smokers.
Okay, I'm about down to the last third of the bowl, and has changed from the beginning. The citrus is almost completely gone for me. It's all just floral essence and the different tobacco nuances. Not really getting maybe just a hint of the grassiness, but not much of that. Never really got the raisins other than in the tin note, but none of that for me translated into the smoke. So really it's all been about, for me, the Lakeland essence. And it just now, as I'm getting down toward the end, it kind of almost had a similar flavor as that cigar blend cartoon. So not exact, but it's got that different flavor to it. And I think that's what draws my interest to a tobacco now, is when it's something different than anything that I've tried before. Now, there is a little bit of a sweetness to it, not intense. It's just, to me, it's not sour. It's got a little bit of sweetness to it, and it's not flat. So florals, a little bit of sweetness in the beginning, some citrus. Like I said, closer to a lime than a lemon for me. Want to buy it again? Yep. Am I going to keep it in stock? Yep. And would I recommend it? Yep. I mean, even if you try and you don't like it, there's plenty of people out there that do like it, that you can trade for or pass it along. So, two thumbs up for me on St. Bruno. And even if I hated it, I'd still get to sit at the cool kids table now because I tried it. So, if you haven't tried it and you want a seat at the cool kids table, give it a try. So, all right, that wraps it up, and I will catch you all on the next one.